Hi guys, welcome to the short videos. You're learning Math with Mazhar. Today I've taken a YGCSE past year paper wherein we are solving the question which is related to the topic function. I've got three functions given to me, f of x, g of x and h of x, and I need to work it out the following bits in that. So let's just first start off with the given thing, a bit, which is h of 4. It means wherever h function you have, plug in 4 in place of x. So h of 4 basically over here, I have 4 raised to x, so 4 raised to 4, 4 times 4 if you do, you're going to get 256 because 4 square is 16, 16 times 16 is 256. Now f g of 1, basically it is the composition function that you have that we have to do. G of 1 value should be plug in back in the f function. So g of 1 means in place of x is the g function 1. 1 you will substitute, you're going to get 2. This 2 should go in the f function. That's what you will get, f of g of 1, which is basically the composition function. So now in f function, plug in 2, you're going to get 6 plus 2, 8, and that's your answer. Now the third bit is g circle f of x, again the composition function, but the first function means f function should go in g, and we need to write it in the form of a polynomial, which is basically a quadratic polynomial given to us. So f function must go in g. What is your f function? Entire 3x plus 2 should be replaced with the g function. So that is g of, first write it down because working we have to work out. Now g, this is 3x plus 2 because it has a square plus 1 in the g function. Now 3x plus 2 whole square is a binomial. So square of a binomial, we need to work it. The square of a binomial in the sense like I can do it in two ways. Either I can use the algebraic identity or I can expand it by just multiplying the same bracket two times. So if I do with the algebraic identity a plus b whole square, I'm going to get a square plus b square plus twice of first term and the second term. Plus 1 was already there. So 3x square will give me 9x square plus 4 plus 12x plus 1. And ultimately in the form of the way they have given us, x square and then x term and the constant, we can add up 4 plus 1, that is 5. Moving on to the next question in that, we need to work out x when f of x equals to g of 7. So first get g of 7, that is by substituting 7 in the g function, I'm going to get the value 7 square plus 1, that is 49 plus 1, 50. F of x, I have 3x plus 2. So equate that. 3x plus 2 equals to 50. So I'll get my x value after subtracting 2 from both sides, that is 48. X equals to dividing by 3. I'll get 3 times 1 and 3 times 6, 16. Moving on to the inverse, finding inverse function for the f of x, which is given to us as a linear function, 3x plus 2. Just inverse follows like two ways you can do, either swapping or you can do it like let f of x is equals to y, basically the image, and x becomes like f inverse y. So you can do that. Plug in f of x is equals to y here, 3x plus 2. Swapping in the sense like you switch it and make x as a subject basically. So y minus 2 over 3. And in place of x, if I substitute f inverse y, so my inverse in terms of x would be x minus 2 over 3. I can write it as x minus 2 over 3 by swapping x as y. So this is my inverse function, and that's how your working should be. Moving on to the next one, we have g of x over f of x plus x, and give your answer in a single function in terms of x in its simplest form. So g of x divided by f of x function, g of x is, if we go back, we have x square plus 1 over 3x plus 2. We'll write it x square plus 1 over 3x plus 2. The both functions are given to us, plus x. So this we can do it by taking LCM or multiplying with 3x plus 2 across. So x square plus 1 plus x times 3x plus 2 over 3x plus 2, because we need to have a fraction, proper fraction. So write it properly, 3x plus 2, I'll just rub it out. Now, how to do this is expanding the bracket and check for the like term, 3 times x square plus 2 times of x over 3x plus 2. See, I have the like term over here, which will give me 4x square plus 2x plus 1 over 3x plus 2. If we can find the factors, it's okay. Otherwise, we can stop it over here. This is our answer for this one. And the finally, GVIT, find X when H inverse X is equals to 2. Remember, our H of X function given to us in the question is 4 raised to X. Now, I need to have, as I told, swapping of X, or basically get the inverse of this one, whose value is already given. We need to work out for what value of X. So as we go with the exponent type of things, which is the reverse process of logarithm. So if I have to write it like that, if I take it this way, I'm going to get log y to the base 4, which will give me x, which is my subject now. I mean, I've converted and found the inverse. So this is h inverse x is equals to log of x base to 4. So this value is given to me as 2. So now for what value of x, I'm going to get this as equal to this one. So if I swap it again, this is going to be very easier. X is equals to 2 raised to 4, which means 2 raised to 4 is nothing but 16. So my value of X is over here, 16. I hope you like the video. Please like, share, and subscribe for more such videos for IGCSE previous year papers. Thanks for watching.